Hi everyone, today it was another day of freestyle chess and Carlsen faced Abdusattorov in semifinals. So let's quickly jump into the game. Carlsen played g4 move with the idea of restricting black to play f5. So let's say for instance f5, gf, rook f, and now c3 would be very strong. White attacks rook. So in this position, Abdusattorov goes for e5, grabbing the center. We have knight to g3, developing a piece, f6, now bishop is open, and here d4. Actually, in this position, Carlsen sacrificed a pawn, so very interesting move, not the best, and here knight to b6 was played by Abdusattorov. So let's consider here taking. Now probably white plan would be to play f4, and after knight to g6, bishop takes, and b6, but in this position actually black is a little bit better. How about after ed, knight f5, attacking a pawn, but here we can play c5, defending, knight takes g7, and here very good move, queen to g6, attacking knight here, but now we can grab this pawn on g4. So after knight to b6, knight d3 was played. Again, we can take here, and then f3 would follow. But Abdusattorov played a little bit timid move with d6. Bishop to f3 was played. Now here ed, bishop takes, and c5, advancing a pawn, and also attacking a bishop. Bishop has to return. And here, actually, bishop to c7 is the best move. But Abdusattorov goes for c4, and Carlsen took his opportunity. He took on b6, now black will have double pawns, so white is a little bit better here. And now, very good move, knight to b4, knight enters the position. The knight is already very dangerous here on b4, it can very hardly be attacked. So d5, and now c3. So white is guarding all of the important squares, and his position is quite nice. Bishop to f4. Trying to restrict some castling, but now knight to h5 was played by Carlsen. Actually, here computer suggests knight f5, and after g6, we can insert this intermediate move e3, and after bishop returns, knight jumps here, and white is better. After knight h5, bishop went back. Yeah, bishop was under attack. Now we have f4. Carlsen is advancing his pawns. Long castle, knight returned to g3 with idea to knight to f5, and here g6, black prevents that. Also possible in this position, instead of g6 was this d4, but probably Abdusattorov was afraid of this check, king b8, and castling longs. So g6, we have e3, queen d7, queen e2, rook f to e8, knight jumps here, and knight is trying to go to d4, bishop to f4, and here Carlsen finds really nice move actually with the b4. So what to do in this position? If we take en passant, then suddenly a rook is open on a file. But if black doesn't take, that actually happened in the game, after let's say bishop to e6, but now white has this excellent square for his knight on d4. So h3, just guarding the knight, and here h5 was played. Quite a risky move by Abdusattorov. Better would be just to play f5, locking this bishop, and after gf, bishop takes, knight takes, queen can enter here, queen d7 and king to d2, and actually computer says this position is quite good for black. And after this h5, actually f5 is the best move, and let's say after knight here, now we can take here, queen has to take, and knight can go to d4, so quite complicated position, queen f5, and bishop here. This is computer variation, but yeah, very hard to see. So Carlsen played knight to d4, attacking a bishop. Now ag was played, another bad move by Abdusattorov. Better would be just to go h4, kicking this knight. Let's say again, intermediate move by f5. Bishop goes back and knight enters here on h1. So that would be better move. But Abdusattorov took, and now Carlsen played again, very good move, f5, attacking the bishop. So what happens if black takes? Now knight takes here, take, and this would be horrible, queen is lost. So after f5, bishop to f7 was played, but now we take there, queen to c7, queen f3, white's defends the knight, bishop goes to h6, now rook to e1, again very good move, preparing the e4, bishop goes to g5, and here Carlsen plays really nice move, a4, idea is a5 to open a file and go for checks and go for a black king. So gf, bishop takes, yeah, here if we take with a pawn, then bishop h4 is quite good. So that was good move by Carlsen, taking the bishop. King has to go to b8, and in this position actually Carlsen played rook to e2, which wasn't the best move. Better would be just to go a5 and opening up black's king. So rook to e2, knight goes to g6, now bishop takes, bishop takes, another knight. So as you can see in this position, white actually has a beautiful knights here in the center, and bishop pair is very bad for black, which is very unusual that bishop pair is worse than two knights. So in this position actually bishop takes would be the best, knight takes, but Abdusattorov goes for queen to e5, not the best move. We have a5 attacking the pawn, and again here just queen to e4 was a mistake. Better would be just to take here first, rook takes a5, and now go queen to e4. Here the if white avoids trade with queen to g3 check, now rook e5, looks like that this is very dangerous, but now queen to d3, and actually black is winning in this position. Let's say king goes here, but now we can already take, and this check actually is not that dangerous at all. So after this move, instead of queen to g3 in this position, queen takes would be the best, rook takes, rook there, and queen to c7 is quite safe, rook check, but now we can go just to b8, and this would be a draw. But after queen to e4, Carlsen just took, and here the best would be just to take with a pawn, but Abdusattorov took with a rook, ab6. Now this king is in a lot of trouble, he cannot escape, and there will be huge mating threats soon. So rook takes g4, there, check. So Carlsen forced the exchange of the rooks, and now rook to e8 was played, attacking here, rook to h1. In this position actually rook to f8 was a huge blunder, but what to do in this position? Actually, computer suggests bishop to f4, or even taking here first, the knight, knight takes bishop f4, so attacking here, king d2, now we have bishop here, and after knight e7, we can actually play f5, and here if white takes on d5, then rook d8 actually is a draw, because also bishop is guarding this h8 square. So that would be very interesting line, but actually here after f5, white can take here, and white is still a little better. But after rook to f8, Carlsen went to knight to d6, and actually in this position, funnily enough, Abdusattorov resigned. He realized that, yeah, these knights are too powerful, but let's see maybe why he resigned. Let's do a random check, like bishop to d3, it's a good move. King goes to d2, but now, let's say after rook to g8, the problem is now this knight to e6 is coming to c5, and there'll be huge threats with checks, potential checks, and mates here. So imagine I will do a random move, like, for instance, let's go here. Now, this knight c5. Let's go back, and this would be already check. King cannot go here, and this would be nasty checkmate. So yeah, so what to do in this position? After, where were we? Knight here. So again, king d2. Let's say just rook is waiting. So again, let's do another random move. But now knight c5. Let's do another random move. And also, yeah, this one. Oh, let's try here to defend against this check. Yeah, this line I wanted to show you. But now check. And if we take, this would be again checkmate, actually. So very nice game by Carlsen, and tomorrow it's another round. So if Abdusattorov wins, there will be tie breaks, but if not, Carlsen is in the final. So guys, thank you for watching as always, and please like, share and subscribe, and I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye.